हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न टॉपिक टुडे माइक्रोब्स इन ह्यूमन वेलफेयर। स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज चैप्टर 10 ऑफ क्लास 12। दिस इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट चैप्टर बिकॉज इट इज डायरेक्टली रिलेटेड टू आवर किचन्स, आवर इंडस्ट्री एज वेल एज मेनी प्रोडक्ट्स दैट फॉर्म इनसाइड under these chapters which are directly related to the human being. Students, microbes, as you know that according to class 9th and some part of class 11th, you have studied as a chapter infectious diseases where the role of microorganism already taught. Microorganism friend or foe, how can you decide and how it is categorized into the category of friend and in the category of foe. In class 11th, you have already learned about different type of microorganism including from bacteria and protozoa, fungi and many other. But out of which all these basically 2-3 group of microorganism are categorized in this, like bacteria and fungi in manufacturing of different type of products that are directly or indirectly useful for the humans. Okay, students, let us start this chapter by general history of microbes. Microbes are those microorganisms basically which cannot understand simply by seeing them naked eye. It is only categorized on the basis of by observing with microscope what is their morphology, their physiological function and what type of function performed in our foods for making different type of products. Now students, let us start this chapter. The first part in this chapter is microbes in household. Before this, I'm talking about the overview of this chapter. Generally, in this chapter, we learn about how the microbes help in formation of different type of products. Now, the use of microbes in household. Microbes in household products. Microbes in household products. This is the first use of microbes. The second use of microbes is microbes in industry or in biogas production. Microbes in industry or in biogas production. The third use of microbes is in sewage treatment plants. Sewage treatment plants. How the different type of sewage that are moved through the sewer lines at a particular locations where the microbes generally used for the treatment of that sewage and especially the treated water discharge into the water bodies and different type of sludge that are removed from that and used as a manure and fertilizer production. This is a sewage treatment plant. The third here, fourth function is here, students, no biogas is written, I think. Industry only. The fourth thing is a biogas production. The fifth importance of this is biocontrol agent. How the microbes and their different type of products are used to control different type of microbial agents. This is under the biocontrol agent. And other importance of microorganism in production of biofertilizer. Biofertilizer. Students, so this one is a different aspect that is cover, this all is aspect cover in this chapter, chapter 10, microbes in human welfare. This is also important chapter, and many long and short question answer questions are arise in board examination. This is a very important chapter. Now students, let's start with its application. The first is microbes in household products. Okay, this one is the importance of microbes, first importance. You know that in your home different type of products are prepared in which directly use of microbes takes place. The first is the microbes in household products is formation of curds. Curds manufacturing, curds formation. Second one is a dosa and idli formation. Third is a cheese formation, bread formation, and the next one is a toddy manufacturing, toddy formation. This is a different products that are formed at local level by different group of peoples. Sometimes at, you can say at this, these are one is a form at the home and at home level. Now this is a curd. You know that the curd is a important household products that are formed by using curd manufacturing. Part of curd formed by generally using old curd, and it is called germen. This curd is added into the a definite temperature milk having temperature of about 40 to 45 degree centigrade, in which this bacteria is added, and this bacteria further convert milk into the curd by adding some of the lactic acid bacteria. It is also called lactobacillus. Lactic acid bacteria is also called lactobacillus. Okay, generally milk having a sugar called lactose. Lactose is a type of disaccharides, and this lactose convert into the lactic acid with the help of bacteria called lactic acid bacteria, lactobacillus, and this lactic acid help into the conversion of milk into the curd. And this lactic acid bacteria not taken from any additional laboratories. It is taken from old curd that are prepared already. A single few gram of curd having thousand, millions, even in billions of bacteria in them that are going to the new milk, added into the new milk in the form of old curd, and this bacteria repeatedly divide and they form milk into the curd. Generally, this is an important household products that are prepared almost all home of our country. This is a very important thing. Now The second is a dosa idli. Basically, it is a South Indian dish, but nowadays they are prepared in almost all over the world. This is the important dish of the. This is the important dish of the. Of our daily diet, dosa and idli, especially the dough, especially the rice, dough and wheat dough, generally placed by adding some of the bacteria, and this bacteria especially ferment the food starch, especially glucose, and form carbon dioxide and alcohol. This carbon dioxide especially help in the formation of pore, because carbon dioxide never retain at a particular retain in the dough, and even they are placed in the at hot temperatures, they start leaving that, and they form porous dough. And this जैसे हम कह सकते हैं कि जो हम rice लेते हैं या wheat लेते हैं, उसमें कुछ bacteria क्या कर देते हैं, fermenting bacteria मिला देते हैं, जिसके वजह से क्या होता है कि जो fermenting जो rice है या आटा है, उसमें वो bacteria क्या करता है, glucose को तोड़ देता है carbon dioxide and alcohol में. ये कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड निकलना चाहता है, लेकिन ये क्या कर देता है, निकल ना पाने की वजह से एक बड़ा सा स्पेस क्रिएट कर देता है. इस वजह से वो पूरा डग जो हम गूंथे हुए हैं आटे को, वो पूरा का पूरा एक पोरस फॉर्म में कन्वर्ट हो जाता है, और ये फॉर्म करता है डोसा एंड इडली. व्हाट इज देयर एक्चुअल प्रोसीजर of the formation, you can see at your home, because many of the home they are prepared nowadays. Now the cheese is one of the important products that are formed by the by using different group of bacteria. Cheese generally many types. Normal cheese, cottage cheese, Swiss cheese, and Roquefort cheese. This is a different type of cheese. Generally, normal cheese you can purchase many times from the shops, how they are prepared. Normal cheese, in the normal cheese preparation, generally the milk are boiled, and after that the old milk cheese water placed in that help in the coagulation of that milk, and that milk is further filtered and filtrate is removed outside, and they are coagulated cheese. They are prepared generally normally, no extra time taken to them to ferment it and coagulate it, to add different type of nutrient in it. Students, one thing I want to told you, that the lactic acid bacteria in the milk at the formation of curd, they also add vitamin B12. This is a vitamin B12 is especially in the curd that are found additionally, that are synthesized by lactic acid bacteria. This vitamin B12 protect the stomach from different type of harmful microorganism. Okay, so this one is I'm talking about the cheese. This is a normal cheese, and the second one is a cottage cheese. Cottage cheese by inoculum of Streptococcus lactis. This is prepared by a bacteria called Streptococcus lactis. Streptococcus lactis. This bacteria help in the formation of cottage cheese. This is the help in the formation of cottage cheese, especially. It is allowed to milk into the curdle. Curdle means cheese, curd like structure. Coagulation of the milk they form in this also by the help of Streptococcus lactis. Sometimes Lactobacillus lactis is also used. lactobacillus lactis is a lactobacillus lactis are generally used. Here these two cheese is not given in NCERT. This is a told you, I think I teach you additionally. Now this is a Swiss cheese. Swiss cheese is the important cheese that are prepared by using a bacteria known as Propionibacterium Propionibacterium sarmani. This is a prepared by Swiss cheese prepared by Propionibacterium sarmani. This bacteria generally used at the formation of Swiss cheese at the time of milk into curdle. This bacteria generally used, and this bacteria make cheese into the porous. Make cheese into the porous form. Okay, this Propionibacteria produce large amount of CO2, and that CO2 help in the formation of porous cheese. And this porous cheese generally formation of cheese that is highly tasty as compared to normal cheese. Here it is I think when I was in class 12, then it was learned by me by using some of the trick told by teacher. Known Swiss cheese, Swiss is a part, you can say the part of Switzerland. Sarmenai, Propiani, it is a Sarmakar Switzerland guy. It means Swiss cheese. Swiss is a part of Switzerland, and Sarmenai means Sarmaji. This was the topic is the Swiss cheese prepared by Propionibacterium sarmenai, and that add enough amount of producing enough amount of CO2 that make cheese porous. This is a Sarmakar Switzerland guy. That means a trick that by which this topic you can remember. Okay, now second is a Roquefort cheese. Roquefort and Swiss cheese, what is the difference between this? Swiss cheese generally prepared by using bacteria. Swiss cheese generally prepared by using bacteria, Propionibacterium sarmenai, but Roquefort cheese is prepared by a fungus known as Penicillium Roqueforti. This Penicillium Roqueforti, this fungus, this is a fungus, and this is a bacterium. This fungus generally add enough amount of carbon dioxide. How this carbon dioxide form? Students, I want to explain you this again, how this carbon dioxide form inside the food. Especially, you know that the carbon dioxide production in one of the biological degradation. This is the type of anaerobic respiration. Here, glucose first converted into the pyruvic acid by glycolysis, and this pyruvic acid further form ethyl alcohol and carbon dioxide. Here in the cheese production, this carbon dioxide is important. Cheese production, this carbon dioxide is generally used, but this is a ethyl alcohol at the time of manufacturing of beverages. But here, not talking about the ethyl alcohol, I am talking about only carbon dioxide. So this one is a glucose converted into the carbon dioxide is called anaerobic respiration. This is called anaerobic respiration. Okay. So this carbon dioxide generally, especially in the rectified cheese, Swiss cheese, especially starch are found in the form of lactose. This is a disaccharide, and that disaccharide further convert into the glucose, and glucose converted into pyruvic acid and then into carbon dioxide. This carbon dioxide add in enough amount in the cheese, and they are also add extra supplement in this, and it also more delicious as compared to normal cheese. This is a Roquefort cheese prepared by Penicillium roqueforti. This is a type of fungus. So this one is a third product, household product. Now fourth one is a bread manufacturing. You know that bread manufacturing, base of bread industry is a baker yeast. Base of bread industry, bread, or you can say this is also known by bakery industry, is baker yeast, and baker yeast is Saccharomyces cerevisiae. This Saccharomyces cerevisiae generally used for manufacturing of baker yeast, especially in the bread. Any dough it is also known as, जैसे हम इसको बोलते हैं गूथा हुआ आटा, उसमें क्या करते हैं ईस्ट मिला देते हैं, बेकर ईस्ट स्पेशली Saccharomyces cerevisiae पाउडर ईस्ट मिला देते हैं, इसको कुछ और के लिए छोड़ देते हैं. देन दिस बेकर ईस्ट स्पेशली फर्मेंट द जो आटे का शुगर है उसको क्या करता है, ये डाइसैक्राइड है, उसको तोड़ता है. तोड़ करके ये क्या करता है, सेम यही प्रोसीजर फॉलो होता है, ग्लूकोज पाइरुविक एसिड कन्वर्ट इनटू द कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड बाय एनारोबिक रेस्पिरेशन. दिस कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड जनरली ऐड इन दिस आटे में, कह सकते हैं इन दिस डोक में, उठा गोथा हुआ आटे में इसको ऐड करता है, और धीरे धीरे ये पूरा कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड पूरे आटे में फैल जाता है. जब इसको हम एक्स्ट्रा हीट प्रोवाइड करते हैं, व्हेन वी प्रोवाइड एक्स्ट्रा हीट टू देम, तो ये क्या होता है, पूरा वो अब कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड निकलना चाहता है हाई टेम्परेचर को लेकर, तो जैसे ही निकलना चाहता है तो पूरा वो ब्रेड जो होता है या फिर कोई केक होता है वो पूरी की पूरी पोरस हो जाती है और फूल जाती है. तो ये एक बेस है किसका, ब्रेड मैन्युफैक्चरिंग का. डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ बेकरी प्रोडक्ट्स नाउ अ डे यू कैन सी, इंक्लूडिंग फ्रॉम मैन्युफैक्चरिंग ऑफ केक टू द ब्रेड एज वेल एज डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ अदर प्रोडक्ट्स दैट आर फॉर्म बाई दिस Saccharomyces cerevisiae members. Especially this is a type of fungus, and this fungus is the base of the bakery industry. What procedure follow? Especially the Saccharomyces cerevisiae convert the dough glucose into the carbon dioxide. So this one is a the product of bakery industry. Now the third one is a toddy. Toddy, you know, in palm tree, especially in our regions or in majority in South India, because majority palm tree or coconut tree are found there, and date palm are also found there. Here is also some coconut and date palm are also found in the vicinity of Gorakhpur. So this one is a you can say that the toddy especially extract by using अर्थन पॉट, एक घड़ा लेकर एक आदमी पेड़ पे चढ़ जाता है, स्टेम के कुछ पोर्शन क्या करता है, कट करता है, या फिर जहाँ कोकोनट लगा होता है उसके डंठल को कट करता है और उसी पर क्या करता है, पूरा एक वो घड़ा बांध देता है और लगभग में 24 or 12 hours के लिए छोड़ देता है. उसके बाद वहाँ से पूरा टॉडी क्या होता है, निकलता है, अर्थन पॉट में इकट्ठा होता है, फिर उसके बाद वो निकाला जाता है, और निकाल करके उसको लोग डायरेक्टली एज अ डेलिशियस डाइट के तौर पे कुछ लोग पीते हैं. कुछ लोग क्या करना चाहते हैं, इसी में थोड़ा सा कारीगरी कर देते हैं. इसमें क्या कर देते हैं, कुछ फर्मेंटिंग बैक्टीरिया मिला देते हैं, फर्मेंटिंग बैक्टीरिया, एंड दिस फर्मेंटिंग बैक्टीरिया इज हेल्प टू फर्मेंट टाडी शुगर इनटू द अल्कोहल, टाडी शुगर इनटू द अल्कोहल। वो थोड़ा सा बैड स्मेल टाइप का हो जाता है और लोग उसको जो एज अ ड्रिंक लेना चाहता है उसको लेता है और उससे थोड़ा बहुत उसको प्लेजर नशा इस तरह का फील होता है। तो ये टाड़ी में भी एक ट्रेडिशनल फूड है जो जो क्या होता है इसको प्रिपेयर किया जाता है। तो मैंने आज आपको ये बताया कि कैसे एक डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ डिफरेंट ग्रुप ऑफ बैक्टीरिया डिफरेंट प्रोडक्ट्स फॉर्मेशन में, बैक्टीरिया और फंजाई डिफरेंट प्रोडक्ट फॉर्मेशन में यूज़ होते हैं और इनका क्या एप्लीकेशन है। होप कि आपको ये अच्छे से समझ में आया होगा। इसके बाद हम नेक्स्ट क्लास में हम लोग ये पढ़ेंगे कि कैसे माइक्रोब्स का यूज इंडस्ट्री में है, इंडस्ट्री में जैसे वाइन बेवरेजेस प्रोडक्शन में है। हाँ, एक चीज़ मैं आपको क्लियर कर देना चाहता हूँ, ये जो है ब्रेड का एक बेकरी इंडस्ट्री है, बट वन ऑफ द अनदर इंडस्ट्री इज कॉल्ड बेवरेजेस। इट इज़ अ इंडस्ट्री ऑफ प्रोडक्शन ऑफ डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ बियर वाइन बोथ का एंड मेनी मोर, एंड दिस इज कॉल्ड ब्रेवर, ब्रेवर ईस्ट जनरली यूज देयर, एंड ब्रेवर एंड बेकर ईस्ट बोथ आर सेम। सैकेरोमाइसिस यूज इन द बेकरी इंडस्ट्री एंड सैकेरोमाइसिस ऑल्सो यूज इन द सम ऑफ द बैक्टीरिया आर ऑल्सो देयर इन द ब्रेवर इंडस्ट्री या बेवरेजेज इंडस्ट्री। एंड बिसाइड दिस इन इंडस्ट्रियल यूज वी आर ऑल्सो लर्न अबाउट द एंटीबायोटिक प्रोडक्शन एज वेल एज डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ केमिकल एंजाइम्स एंड अदर बायोएक्टिव कंपाउंड प्रोडक्शन। थैंक यू स्टूडेंट्स, इन नेक्स्ट क्लास आई विल टीच अबाउट द माइक्रोब्स इन इंडस्ट्री। थैंक यू।